Good morning, students. So in the last class we have studied about fertilization and implantation, but in this class we will be studying about the pregnancy and embryonic development. So these are steps which take after fertilization and implantation. Okay, so during the, if you can remember, during implantation what happens, that the blastocyst will give rise to a trophoblast layer and inner cell mass will develop as embryo. Okay, so in this, after implantation, so trophoblast layer, whatever is formed in the trophoblast layer, many finger-like projections, projections will appear. Okay, so these finger-like projections are called as chorionic villi. Okay, so you can see here these finger-like projections. Okay, these are known as chorionic villi. Okay, generally what happens, these chorionic villi are surrounded by the uterine tissue and the maternal blood. Okay, so these chorionic tissue or chorionic villi are surrounded by uterine tissue and maternal blood. Okay, so you can see here, these are the chorionic tissue, and surrounding this we will find blood, maternal blood, and the uterine tissue. These are present inside the uterine tissue, right? So these are surrounded by the uterine tissue and maternal blood, right? So this chorionic tissue, chorionic villi along with uterine tissue, okay, they form a special junction. Okay, so that junction will support the chorionic villi along with the uterine tissue will form a junction, or they form in a such a way that there will be a barrier between the maternal body as well as the fetus. Okay, so that barrier is called as placenta. Okay, I try to tell you, this will become a placenta. You can see placental villi. Okay, I'll tell you, the chorionic villi along with uterine tissue form a special barrier between mother body and the developing embryo. Okay, so that barrier is known as placenta. Okay, so that means the chorionic villi along with uterine tissue, they together, you can see this junction. This junction is called as, this is the barrier, or it separates the mother body from the fetus, right? So this is the embryo which is developing inside, and outside this the mother body is there. Okay, so this is the separate barrier. So that barrier is known as placenta. It is a special type of barrier. It has several functions to do. What are those functions? That we'll try to understand first. Okay. Now we will do this. Right? Placenta. Okay. placenta is a barrier between the mother body as well as the developing embryo. The function of main placenta is to supply oxygen and nutrition to the developing embryo. Supply oxygen and nutrition to the embryo. Okay, so second function is it also removes carbon dioxide and excretory wastes from the embryo. Okay, so you see here it is a special type of barrier because this baby is developing inside the fetus or inside the womb. Okay, so it also needs oxygen and it also needs nutrition for the development, and it will also respire so that the carbon dioxide should be removed and the excretory weights also need to be removed. Okay, so the placenta gives a platform through which the developing embryo gets its oxygen and nutrition, as well as it will expel carbon dioxide and excretory waste products towards the outside, towards the mother body. So finally the mother body will release the excretory products outside. Okay, so here the placenta is a special type of connection which only supplies oxygen and nutrition, not all the body parts. The mother blood is completely devoid of the fetus. For example, the blood will not directly enter into the fetus. Got it? So even though the blood is, mother blood is here, but it is separated by a membrane. Okay? So that membrane, it will form, placenta will form a membrane surrounding the developing embryo. Okay, so anything which has to reach the embryo means it has to pass through the placenta. Anything which has to reach the baby. So, or anyway, you take oxygen, you take nutrition, or you take carbon dioxide should be removed. So, any passage, okay, so is to happen only through the placenta. Got it? So, without placenta, nothing will come inside or nothing will go out. Okay, so this placenta is a special barrier, okay, which separates the baby from the mother body. Okay, so the main functions of placenta is supply of oxygen and nutrition to the developing embryo, as well as it removes carbon dioxide and excretory waste products from the embryo. Got it? So then apart from this, the placenta will also secrete some hormones. Okay, so what kind of hormones it will secrete, I will try to tell you. Placenta also secretes several hormones. I'm simply write hormones. Okay, so what are the different kinds of hormones it secretes? First one, human chorionic gonadotropin. First hormone is chorionic gonadotropin. Human chorionic gonadotropin. Okay, and it is simply called as HCG. Okay, and the second hormone is human placental lactogen. Okay, human placental lactogen. So simple form is HPL. Human placental lactogen. Along with this, it will also secrete estrogens as well as progesterones. So these are the several hormones secreted by your placenta. So main function of these hormones, okay, human chorionic gonadotropin and human placental lactogen, they jointly control the function of this movement of oxygen as well as removal of excretory waste products. So these hormones will control the activity. Okay, so these two are one more hormone is there that is produced by the ovary. I will write right here. Ovary will release another hormone known as relaxin. Okay, so these three hormones, relaxin, I'll show you. So first human chorionic gonadotropin 1 and human placental lactogen 2 and the relaxin. These three hormones are especially secreted by the woman during pregnancy. Okay, so these three are secreted by the woman only during pregnancy. During pregnancy. Got it? So here the ovarian hormone relaxin, as the name itself indicates, relaxin means it relaxes the muscle. So you see, during the development of embryo, the mother body generally increases in size, especially the stomach portion. Okay, stomach portion is enlarged. Right, so that means there should be the whatever the muscles are there, they need to be relaxed. Right, so to increase in the size, say for example, so this is a I will simply show it like this. If the mother, if this might be the stomach, okay, simply take this as the stomach, so it increases in size like this. Right, so because if the baby or mother stomach has to increase in size, that means the muscles, whatever the stomach muscles are there, they need to be relaxed. Okay, so that relaxation or the relaxing of the muscles is because of the hormone relaxin. Okay, this hormone is ovarian hormone. Okay, so these ovarian hormone relaxin as well as human chorionic gonadotropin and placental lactogen, these three are secreted only during the time of pregnancy, not in other conditions. Got it? So apart from that, the levels of estrogen, I will write here only, the levels of estrogen, progesterone, as well as, I will remove this. Okay, we will try to remove this, okay? I will tell you one more time. The levels of estrogen, progesterone, cortisol, and some other enzymes. Some other hormones such as prolactin. And thyroxin. So these are hormone levels in the normal woman compared to the normal one. In pregnancy condition, the levels of these hormones increases rapidly. Okay, high levels, I will simply write high levels of hormone secretion. Hormone secretion during pregnancy. Okay, that means the level of estrogen, progesterone, cortisol, prolactin, thyroxin, the level of these hormones is at its peak during pregnancy. Okay, so the role of these high levels of hormones, that these levels are essential for the maintenance of, or simply these high levels of the hormone, they support support the fetal development. Fetal development. Second is mother metabolic activity. Fetal development and the metabolic changes in the mother. Metabolic changes in the mother, as well as the maintenance of the pregnancy. Okay, and these three are the functions. Support the fetal, these hormones. The high levels of estrogen, progesterone, cortisol, prolactin, as well as thyroxine. They release during the pregnancy, the release is high levels. Okay, the high levels of these hormones, they generally support the fetal development. Metabolic, they also support the metabolic changes in the mother. Okay, and maintenance of the pregnancy. These are necessary for all these functions. Okay. So these are the type of hormones which are secreted during the pregnancy. So next, we'll try to understand what happens to the, these are the, whatever the, till now whatever we have studied is the surrounding portion. Okay, placenta and the hormones. So, and what about the inner mass? What is the status of it? That we'll try to look now. Okay. So till now we have studied only the surrounding. The placenta will be surrounded. Okay, what are the functions? What are the hormones it releases? By releases placenta releases, and what ovary releases, and what changes which occur outside the embryo. Okay, now we will try to understand what happens in the inside the embryo. Okay. So just again we will come here just after implantation. Again we have come one more time that after implantation the inner cell mass or embryo, I'll simply write inner cell mass or embryo differentiate to develop outer ectoderm, inner endoderm, okay, and in between this one more layer will form, that is known as middle mesoderm. First ectoderm and endoderm will develop, after that the mesoderm will develop inside, in between the ectoderm and endoderm. Okay, so inner cell mass gives rise to the outer ectoderm and inner endoderm, and in between that the middle mesoderm is also developed. Okay, so these three layers, they give rise to the various kinds of tissue. Okay, and for in the adults those tissue will become as organs. Got it? So these ectoderm, middle mesoderm and endoderm give rise to tissues. These tissues will become organs in adults. Okay, so this tissue will become the tissue portion. So next, okay, so what I said, the after implantation, the inner cell mass embryo differentiate to develop an outer ectoderm, middle mesoderm and inner endoderm. So these three layers give rise to various kinds of tissue, and innermost core, that is embryo, will be having cells. okay? So innermost cells of embryo, cells of embryo, embryo or inner cell mass, inner cell mass will be having or called stem cells, okay, are called stem cells, okay. So these stem cells are very important. So outer layer, so these ectoderm and endoderm and mesoderm, they are outside the embryo, okay, surrounding the embryo outside the body, sorry, not this, this portion, okay. So embryo will be the inner cell mass, that is embryo, will give rise to the outer layer called as ectoderm and inner layer called as endoderm and middle mesoderm, okay. So this is outside the body, okay, exactly at the center inner cell mass will be there, okay. Those cell mass will give rise to stem cells, those are called as stem cells, the inner cell mass now called as stem cells. These stem cells, they are very potent. They, each stem cell can give rise to a various kinds of tissue. Say for example, so the, here is a tissue, or this is a stem cell. So this stem cell can be converted to any type of organ. It can be converted to skin, it can be converted to lung, it can be converted to heart, blood vessel, or this stem cell can be converted to any type of the tissue in the adult, which we can observe in the adult. So this stem cell will give rise to all kinds of tissues and organs, okay. So we simply call it as, these have high potency, or they have high potency to give stem cells will have high potential to give rise to any kind of tissue or organ, okay. So because of this property of the stem cell, nowadays several stem cell banks are available, okay. So during what happens in future, say for example, in future the baby is developing, in future what happens, some accident or due to some reasons, the failure of organ or removal of any part of the organ, okay. So that can happen. During that point, if that person has stored its stem cell, means the organ will be synthesized, new organ will be prepared, okay. Those can be attached to the same person, okay. So for that technology, nowadays the stem cell banks are available, okay. During pregnancy, what parents generally, what they do, if the mother is pregnant, during that time they will remove some cells and store in a bank, okay. So that is stem cell storage, okay. That we will try to understand in the future classes, okay. So now you just get an idea that stem cells can be stored in the bank, which can be reutilized in the future. Got it? So this is about stem cells. So next part, the further development. Next part is, this is just after implantation. Now what happens during pregnancy? That we will try to understand. Okay. So what is the further developments in the embryo? So that we will try to understand now. Thank you. Okay. Generally, in human beings, the gestation period or the gestation period is 9 months. Okay. In humans. Gestation period is around 9 months. So during these 9 months, the fetal will be developing inside the womb. Okay. So during 9 months, what are the changes that occur? That we'll try to understand. So during the first month of the development, during the first month of the pregnancy, the heart will develop development of heart or formation of heart. And by the end of the first month, okay, in the first month only, heart will be formed, and that heart will be developed. By the end of first month, heart starts beating. Okay, heartbeat start. You can listen the heartbeat of the baby just after 1 month of the pregnancy. Okay, so initial for the first month, in the first month, formation of heart take place, and by the end of the first month, or simply write end year. By the end of first month, you will will be able to listen the heartbeat. Heartbeat can be audible So during the second month, what happens? Second month, beginning of the second month will lead to the formation of limbs and digits. Okay, so these, by the end of the second month, in the second month beginning, what happens? The fingers and hand will start to appear. Okay, so by the end of second month, those are completely visible. You can visually see the head, hand, leg, and fingers. Okay, those are digits, nothing but fingers. So you will be able to see the digits, hand, and limbs. Okay, limbs means legs and as well as hands. Okay, so by the end of second month, you will be able to see limbs and digits. Okay, in the third month, what happens? Generally in third month, the major organ systems are formed. So that is, limbs and digits are completely developed. Fully developed. And appearance of the genital organ. Okay, external genital organ will be developed. Okay, so by the end of fifth month, so during fourth and fifth month, what happens? The appearance of hair on the head as well as fetal movement can be observed. Generally, appearance of first movement of the fetus. Movement
of the fetus as well as appearance of hair on the head.
Okay, so in the 4 month and 5th month, generally what happens, baby or the fetus will start to move. Okay, you can feel the movement of the baby fetus. You can feel the movement of the baby inside the womb. Okay, just touch the stomach on the 4th or 5th month, we'll be able to feel. Say for example, now hair color. Now touch my body. Hey, Papu, what is going on? So after, you will be able to see the movement in the womb. Okay, as well as appearance of hair on the head. By the end of 5th month, so the baby will be moving completely. It is completely motile, as well as the appearance of the hair on the head will be there on the 5th month. Okay, so next on the 6th month, I will remove this. So on the 6th month, what happens? The hair, minute hair, small hairs are, or simply write, appearance of fine hairs or fine hairs on the body as well as appearance of eyelids, eyelashes will appear. They start appearing. Okay, generally what happens, 6 month old, fine hair, sandhu kooju 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 body mele, eyelids formation aagtavu, eyelashes formation aagtavu. Okay, eyelids and eyelashes both will be formed by the end of 6 month. Okay, so now during the by the 6 month, generally by the 6 month what happens, all organs of the body are visible. Okay, almost all organs, but they need to develop, right? So what happens, the second or in the 3rd month itself, heart is formed in the 1st month itself, and in the 2nd month what happens, appearance of limbs and digits. In the 3rd month, appearance of major organ systems, and in the 4th and 5th month, appearance of hair on the head as well as fetal movement. On the 6th month, appearance of fine hairs and the body, eyelids are formed, eyelashes are formed. So that means by the 6 month, almost all organ systems are appearing on the in the baby, will appear in the baby. But in the second time, in the last 3 months, generally 7, 8 and 9 months, what happens, the development, complete development of the baby will take place. Complete development, of the all organs of the baby, all organs of the baby as well as overall development, and overall development of the, or simply write, overall development of the baby. Overall development of the baby will take place. Okay, so by the end of 9 months, the fetus will be completely developed into a complete baby. Okay, so that baby will be ready for the ejection or parturition. So what parturition is, that we will try to understand. Okay, so next part we'll be studying, that is parturition and lactation. Okay, by the end of 9 months, what happens? all organ systems and the complete innermost the digestive system or respiratory system, what all the systems are there, they will completely develop the 7, 8, 9 months. By the end of the 9 months, baby will be completely ready to be delivered outside the body of the mother. Okay, so now we'll try to understand what parturition is. Parturition and lactation. Okay, so parturition means the delivery of the baby. Okay, parturition is nothing but delivery of the baby. Okay, delivery of the baby. Delivery of the baby is known as parturition. Parturition. Okay. So now think that now the 9 months gestation period is over, baby is ready to be ejected or ready to be ejected outside the mother body. Okay. So now what happens? The generally the uterine muscles, the surrounding this uterine muscles will be there. They contract vigorously. Okay. So vigorous contraction of the uterine muscles as well as placenta. Okay. So that lead to the expulsion of the baby outside the mother body through the birth canal. This is the birth canal. Birth canal to the outside world. Okay. So what happens? The uterine muscles will be here. The uterine muscles, these are the uterine muscles and the placenta. They contract vigorously. Okay. By the vigorous contraction of all these muscles, the baby will be expelled out. Okay. So that process is known as parturition. Got it? So why this uterine muscles will contract vigorously, what happens to the placenta, that we'll try to understand now. Okay, so what happens as the fetus develops in right, when fetus is developed fully, okay, as well as fetus developed fully and fetus develop fully and if the baby develops fully, what happens? The size of the baby increases, right? So this will be the size of the baby now. Okay. So baby initially will be small, now the baby is enlarged. Okay, but it is grows. It already grows. So what happens during this time? It will send the signal. Okay. Before signal, I will try to tell you some points. That is, like this, the parturition is generally induced by a complex. You should be right. Parturition is induced by. A complex system, complex neuroendocrine system. Okay, that we call neuroendocrine system. Okay, so neuroendocrine, here nervous system is also involved as well as hormones. Endocrine system is also involved. For that reason, it is called as neuroendocrine system. Okay. So what happens? As the fetus fully developed fetus along with placenta initiates a mild uterine contraction. So developed fetus as well along with placenta initiates a mild uterine contraction. Okay, you see here, as the baby is developing in size, it is increasing size, it will put some pressure on the placenta. Got it? So it will put some pressure on the placenta as well as the uterine muscles. Okay, here uterine muscles will be there, here placenta is there. Okay, so surrounding the baby is placenta. So that increase in size of the baby will induce the uterine muscles as well as the placenta. So what happens? By the development of the fetal baby, a mild contractions will be arise. All the mild contractions will appear in the uterine muscles. Okay, mild contractions, very small. Initially, what happens? Baby delivery because sometimes what can start. Okay, so that is because of the initiation of a contraction of uterine muscles. So that is called as initiation reflux. That is called as initiation reflux. Initiation reflux. Fetal ejection reflux. Sorry, initiation not. Or we will write this as fetal ejection reflux. We will write here. Fetal ejection reflux. Okay. Fetal ejection reflux is nothing but a mild contraction of the uterine muscles. Okay, because of the development of the fetus as well as the placenta. Okay. So that will the development of fetus as well as placenta puts a pressure on the uterine muscles to go under contraction, a mild contraction. So that mild contraction is known as fetal ejection reflux. Got it? Fetal ejection reflux. So now what happens? Move this. Okay. So this fetal ejection reflux. Fetal ejection reflux. Ejection reflux sends signal to the pituitary gland, mother's pituitary gland. Pituitary gland to release a hormone known as oxytocin. Okay. Oxytocin. So what happens? The fetal ejection reflux. So this fetal ejection reflux sends some signal to the pituitary gland in the brain of the mother. Okay. So what happens to the pituitary gland now after receiving the signal? It releases a hormone known as oxytocin. Okay. So this oxytocin is very important for the vigorous contraction of the uterine muscles. So okay, what happens? This oxytocin acts on uterine muscles to cause stronger contractions. Okay, initially what happens in the uterine muscles, a mild contraction is initiated because of the fetal ejection reflux. So this induces the pituitary gland to release a hormone known as oxytocin. So oxytocin comes to the uterine muscles and stimulates the activity so that the uterine muscle will contract in a stronger manner right now. Okay, after receiving the oxytocin, activity of the oxytocin, it causes stronger contractions in the uterine muscles. Okay, so this further uterine muscle, as the uterine muscles start contracting strongly, it further increases the release of oxytocin. Okay, this further releases or stimulates the release of oxytocin. Okay, so what happens is here. So initially, first fetal ejection reflex is there. This sends a signal to a pituitary gland and it releases the oxytocin. Now that the oxytocin causes a stronger contraction in the uterine muscles. Okay, this stronger contraction, then it further stimulates the excess release of oxytocin. Okay, so now the contraction will become even stronger. Okay, so the uterine contraction contractions become even stronger. Okay, so now as it, now what happens, uterine muscles contract rapidly or even strongly, that also releases the oxytocin. Further the oxytocin will come to the uterine muscles. Now the strength of the contraction is even more. Okay, like this, until and unless the embryo is expelled out of the body, this process will be simultaneously taking place. Got it? So the oxytocin induces the uterine muscles so that it can undergo stronger contraction. That further stimulates the release of oxytocin. Again, the oxytocin will come and the strength of the contraction increases. Okay, so this takes place until and unless the baby is expelled out of the body. So that process is known as, this continues till the baby is expelled out of the mother body. So this is known as parturition. Okay, so when the baby comes out of the mother body, the mother womb, so that is called as parturition. Got it? So now, hope you have understood right now. Now, soon after infant delivery, what happens? Just delivery takes place. Just after delivery, what happens? The placenta will be thrown out of the uterus. Okay, so soon after parturition, the placenta is also expelled out of the uterus. Parturition, placenta is also expelled out of the uterus. Okay, so this process is known as parturition. So now the last part of it, that is lactation, that we try to understand. Okay,
lactation.
Okay. So lactation is nothing but the formation of milk in the mammary gland. Okay. So these mammary glands in the female, they undergo differentiation during pregnancy. Okay. So during pregnancy, the mammary glands glands start differentiating. Okay, you are pregnant, during that time only the mammary glands, they differentiate. Okay, so differentiate and they start developing the milk, but the milk production generally start just after the delivery of the baby or start producing milk just after the pregnancy. This process is known as lactation. Okay, the first milk, whatever is produced by the first few days, whatever the mother will produce the milk, so that will be called as colostrum. Okay, the first few days milk is called as colostrum. So this colostrum, will be released only during the first few days, 1, 2, 3, or 3, 4 days, okay, that is first few days. So in the first few days the milk is secreted in the mammary glands, right? So that mammary gland is called as colostrum. So this colostrum is a very important nutritive substance which has to be given to the newborn baby, because this colostrum will be rich in antibodies. Okay, so that antibodies will develop resistance in the newborn baby. Got it? So this colostrum contains several antibodies which is essential for the development of resistance in the newborn baby. Okay, so generally what doctor suggests, initial first few days doctor suggests to the woman that she has to feed the newborn during the first few days. Okay, it is essential, very important, because the colostrum will be rich in several antibodies, okay. So this when these antibodies are taken by the newborn, that antibody will remain throughout its life. Okay, so that will give rise to innate immunity. That we will try to understand later. But so this will give rise to a innate immunity in the newborn. Okay, there are two kinds of immunity: innate and acquired immunity. Okay, so this immunity, which is developed by during the birth of the baby, is called as innate immunity. Okay, so for the development of innate immunity, the colostrum is very important. First few days milk is very important for the development of innate immunity in the newborn. Got it? So this is about the lactation and pregnancy. Okay, so here this ends the other topic, that is human reproduction. Okay, so hope you have understood the topic well, and we'll try to give the notes soon. Okay, thank you.